Hello everyone, my name is Ashra and I'm part of the Azure Identity Advanced Cloud Engineering team within Microsoft. It is important that you keep your Azure ID Connect servers up to date with the latest releases, since these upgrades include fixes to various things like security issues, bugs, its performance, and many more. Keeping this in mind, as an admin, you may want to upgrade your Azure ID Connect server in your environment. Based on the setup and the environment, there are three ways Azure ID Connect upgrades happen: in-place upgrade, automatic upgrades, and swing migration. In this video, let's talk about the in-place upgrade for AD Connect. This method is preferred when you have a single server and less than 100,000 objects. As part of the upgrade, if there are any changes to the out-of-box sync rules, a full import and a full synchronization can automatically occur after the upgrade. This method ensures that the new configuration is applied to all existing objects in the system. Depending on the number of objects in the scope of the sync engine, this run might take a few hours. The normal Delta Sync scheduler that synchronizes every 30 minutes by default is suspended, but password synchronization continues. If there are no changes to the out-of-box configuration with the new Azure ID Connect release, then a normal Delta import or sync starts instead. If you feel the need to defer the full imports and full synchronization steps, you can do so by following our documentation on deferring full synchronization after upgrades. If you have made changes to the out-of-box synchronization rules, then these rules are set back to the default configuration on upgrade. To ensure your configuration is kept between upgrades, make sure you make changes as described in the document on best practices for changing default configuration. If you already changed the default sync rules, before starting the upgrade process, please check our documentation on how to fix modified default rules in Azure ID Connect. Keeping this in mind, you might want to consider doing this activity over the weekend. Now, let's take a quick look at a demo where we do an in-place upgrade of AD Connect. Here, you can see that our AD Connect version is currently at 2.0.28.0. Let's try to upgrade this to the latest version. Here, we have the latest version of AD Connect setup downloaded. Let's go ahead to install this. When the wizard loads up, click on Upgrade. When prompted to enter your Azure ID credentials, please enter your admin credentials there to proceed. You should then see it take some time to eventually proceed with the in-place upgrade. I hope this video helped you understand more about the in-place upgrade for AD Connect. Thanks for watching.